Hello everyone, this video is about the vocabulary that we have used during the time of pandemic. The usage of these words were done both in spoken and written form on every single day to communicate our ideas, thoughts and emotions to others. In this video, I have made an attempt to familiarize all of you to the words that are most commonly used during the period of lockdown. In this slide, I have enlisted some of the words which are most commonly used in this pandemic. The words are virus, incubation period, diagnosed, asymptomatic, social distancing, self-isolation, lockdown, containment zone, quarantine, sanitizer, endemic, epidemic, COVID-yet, pandemic. Let us learn the meaning and the usage of these words. First one. Coronavirus. Any of a group of RNA viruses that cause a variety of respiratory, gastrointestinal, and neurological diseases in humans and other animals. Example, Hari was hospitalized because of the coronavirus. Incubation period. The period of time between harmful bacteria or viruses entering a person's or animal's body or entering a plant and the effect of disease appearing. Example, the average incubation period of the virus is thought to be 5 days. Third one. Diagnosed. To recognize and name the exact character of a disease or a problem by examining it. Example, COVID-19 is diagnosed with a laboratory test. Fourth one, asymptomatic, showing no symptoms of a particular disease. Example, many people were asymptomatic in our area but had received a positive COVID-19 test result today. Fifth one, social distancing. The practice of keeping away from other people as much as possible or keeping a certain distance from other people in order to stop a disease from spreading to a lot of people. Example, we need to maintain social distance at least of 6 feet during this pandemic. Self-isolation. The practice of intentionally keeping yourself separate from other people, organizations, etc. Example, people who are tested coronavirus positive should self-isolate themselves. Seventh one, lockdown. A period of time in which people are not allowed to leave their homes or travel freely because of a dangerous disease. Example, all the schools in our area have been closed as the government announced lockdown. Eighth one, containment zone. According to the Union Ministry for Health and Family Welfare, containment zones are specific geographic areas where COVID-19 positive cases are found in large numbers. Example, during pandemic, many areas are declared as containment zones. Ninth one, quarantine. A special period of time in which a person or animal that has a disease must stay or be kept away from others in order to prevent the spread of the disease. Example, all the infected people are put into quarantine for 15 days. Tenth one, sanitizer. A liquid for washing your hands in order to get rid of harmful bacteria. Example, sanitizing our hands quite often helps us to avoid getting sick. 11th one, endemic. Especially of a disease or a condition regularly found and very common among a particular group or in a particular area. Example, coronavirus is endemic in many parts of the world. 12th one, epidemic. The appearance of a particular disease in a large number of people at the same time. Example, coronavirus is epidemic. 13th one, pandemic. Existing in almost all of an area or in almost all of a group of people, animals or plants. Example, many people pray for an end to pandemic disease throughout the world. 14th one, COVID-yet. Some people who behaves in a stupid way that risk spreading the infectious disease COVID-19. Example, we can see some of the COVID-yets without masks around us. I hope you have all understood the vocabulary related to COVID-19. Now here is an activity for you all. Write a paragraph on COVID-19. Use the vocabulary that you have learned in the given video. Do like, share and subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon because whenever I upload a new video, you will get a notification. All my previous videos links are given in the description box. You can open the links and watch my videos. Thank you.